Hi, my name is Søren Nielsen, and in the previous video, we started on the tools we have available in Spine. Now in this video, we will cover the remaining tools, which are the bone length tool, the post tool, the weights tool, and the create tool. And then we'll have a look at compensation and options. So let's get started. In setup mode and when any transform tool is active, placing the mouse over the tip of the selected bone will allow you to change the length of it. Now, if I select this bone here and I move to the tip, you can see it will show this small icon here and I can drag this icon to change the length of the bone. And down here you see I have my rotate tool active. I could also have translate or scale active and it would still show up when I hover over the tip. I can also change multiple bones at the same time. I do this by just selecting the bone, like so. And I go to the first bone that I selected and I drag out the tip and you can see now I'm actually changing the length of both of the selected bones. This can also be done numerically, and if you look over here on the right side, we have the properties. And now if I enter a number here, for example, I enter in 50, I've changed both bones to have a length of 50 pixels. So, and 500, sorry, let me just try that again. 500, you can see I have two very large bones, but they're both the same length. The next tool is the post tool, which you can find down here because you already have it selected. And the post tool adjusts the bone rotation by using inverse kinematics or just IK. Now, if I select a bone here, you can see I have this small icon here at the top and I can drag this around to rotate the head. But where this tool really shines is if you have multiple bones selected. Like if I take this arm here, select these two bones, you can see I can actually drag the tip here and the last bone in the hierarchy will have will try and target this small icon, like so. Let's undo that. I can also select multiple bones in the usual way by just clicking here and then holding down command. You can see I'm selecting multiple ones, but while I have the post tool active, I actually don't need to hold down command to do a box select. I can just drag here. And now if I hold down command, I can do multiple box selections like so. Another great example of where the post tool is really handy to use is if I open up the Raptor example that we have included and then zoom in again, I'm just going to do box selection around the tail here. You can see now I can actually really easy go and choose where I want to have the tip of the bone here, and all the bones below will match up, so I get a sort of even distribution of the rotation. I'm just gonna go back here again to Spine Boy. Then you actually don't need to keep, you know, changing your selection. You can adjust multiple sets of bones that do not share a common parent without losing the selection. For example, now if I select first these bones here and then these bones here, you can see I can do this. I can move these around like so. And I'm not losing my selection, but because these two chains I have selected here, they do not share any common parents, I can store or keep my selection. So this speeds up time quite a lot because you could then have multiple chains selected and just quickly pose all of them. The weights tool is used in combination with the weights view that will pop up automatically when I click a mesh while the tool is active. And I already have the tool active here. So now if I click this mesh here, you see the view popped up. The weights tool is used to set the influence of bones on vertices of a mesh. We'll be going over how to use the weights tool and the view in a later video. The create tool is used to create new bones, which can only be done when I'm inside of setup mode. And before you can create a new bone, you first have to select the bone that will be the parent. Then by left-clicking and dragging the mouse, I can create a new bone and then set the length of the bone. Let me show you how this is done. So I have the create tool active here and I select the parent and now I click and I drag and this creates a bone and set the length. I can also just do a single click, which will create a serial length bone like this. And you see here we have two bones now. The length of the bone is purely cosmetic, except when you're using IK constraints or the auto weights feature when setting up your weights. A serial length bone will be drawn in the editor, like this crosshair here, instead of the regular bone. And this is also true if you go over here in the tree, and you see we have this bone here, and then we have this bone here. When creating bones, keep in mind that the bones will pivot around their origin when rotated. So for example, if I go here and I create a new bone and I switch to my rotate tool, you can see it will be rotated around where I clicked the first time when I started drawing the bone. But there are no limitations for where a bone is created, and child bones are not required to have their origin at the tip of their parent, as you can see here. Usually when creating new bones, the attachments for the bones are already in the editor area to use as a reference for where to create the bones. And I've imported all the attachments for Spine Boy. So after I select the root bone here, you can see I have all my different slots here. They're all parented to the root. And I have my create tool active. I select this root bone and then I hold down command and I select the neck attachment here. I release command and then I draw a bone and see what happens here. Because I selected the neck, the new bone is called neck and the neck slot and its attachment has been moved to be parented to this bone here. Now I can also parent multiple bones, multiple slots to the bone. And I do this by, again, I hold down command and I select the head attachment first because the first attachment will be used for the name. Then I select all the other attachments, like so. And then I draw a bone here, like this. And now you can see I have a bone here called head, and I have the four attachments for the head already parented to it. Additionally, you can also easily fix a bone that's not quite in the right position. By selecting the bone, I already have this bone selected, and then I hold down the Option key on the keyboard, and then I draw out a new bone. And this just makes it easy for me to actually correct the position of this bone. Any child bones and attachments will be unaffected by this. The color for each bone can also be changed, and we do this by first selecting the bones, and then we can see down here in the properties, if you noticed, I selected two bones, so you can do this on multiple bones at the same time. This is especially useful to differentiate different groups of bones, and it will speed up your selection quite a lot. For example, on Spine Boy here, you can see I've already set all the front bones to be green, and I have the bones in the rear to be red. And then the center bones here for the torso, neck and head, I've colored those yellow. On larger skeletons, this can be a huge time saver. Normally when a bone's transform is adjusted, any attachment or child bones will also be affected. For example, if I take the arm here and I rotate it, you can see the attachments and the bones will follow it. Using compensation allows you to move a bone without this happening. So first what I'll do is I'll enable image compensation here. Then I select the head bone and I'll rotate it. You can see that the bone is rotated, but the attachment is not being moved. What is going on actually here is that the attachment is transformed in the opposite amount of the bone, so it appears to not change. This works for all attachments in setup mode, but in animate mode, some attachments can be transformed. For example, in animate mode, image compensation will work on mesh attachments, but not for region attachments. So if I now switch into animate mode and I rotate the bone, you can see the head will actually, or the attachment will actually follow, despite me having compensate on. I'll go back into setup mode. To move a bone without affecting child bones, we then enable bone compensation. And now I can go and select the arm here and I can rotate it. You can see that the child bones are not rotated with it. I can also translate it like so. So let me undo that. This can also be used in animate mode, but you will need to make sure the children are keyed as well. And the interpolation between keys may still cause the bones to move. I'll talk more about this later on. Also, be sure to disable compensation when it's no longer needed just to avoid confusion. So I'll disable this. Also, the last thing to note is if a bone has non-uniform scaling, meaning if the X scale is not the same as the Y scale, then due to how attachment positions are described, image compensation may not be able to adjust the attachment so it appears like it's not moving. So let me show you what this means. So if I take and I select the head bone here and I scale it down so it's non-uniform, you can see that we have different X and Y scale. And I turn on image compensation and I rotate the bone. We end up with something that's looking quite funky, but it's not really what we want. The options panel that we have down here will give you convenient access to toggling your selection, your visibility, and your name tags for bones and attachments. The first column that we have here controls whether bones, region and mesh attachments, or bounding boxes can be selected. And this makes some tasks easier by preventing accidental selection. The next column here will control your visibility of the same items, your bones and so on. And it's often useful to hide bones to reduce the clutter while you're animating. So let me try and do that. So I've hidden the bones here and you can see I can still actually select the bones if I hover over them. So even though they're not visible, they're still selectable. If I wanted to make them not selectable, I would also have to toggle this off here and I'll put this back on and also this here. So the third column controls visibility of name tags, and name tags will increase the amount of clutter for complex skeletons, but it can sometimes make it easier to find a specific bone or attachment in the editor view. So for example, I could turn this off or on, sorry, for bones, and you can see and now they get the names here and I can actually click the names to do the selection. I can also do this for images and bounds. So in this particular scene, I don't have any bounds visible though. Okay, so this covers the tools in Spine. I mentioned IK and meshes in this video, and they will be covered in future videos. For the next video though, we will start looking into animation, and I hope you learned something, and I hope to see you again in the next video. So, bye for now.